The live fight action is about to start here on ringside. Lots for myself and Billy Schwer, one of our top lightweights, to get our teeth into the studio here as well, into the program here as well. First up tonight, though, one of the best flyweights in Europe, Mickey Cantwell, a courageous and determined pro, as you'll find anywhere. He was an excellent amateur who turned pro rather late at the age of 27, but he made up for lost time before he was halted by serious illness in 1992. Now he's fought his way into championship class, and he thrilled us on Sky last time out as he fought for the vacant WBC International Light Flyweight crown against the Mexican Pablo Tiznado.
That's good stuff from Cantwell. Getting through with the jabs and the hook. He's working so hard. Oh, right cross was a good shot from Cantwell. But ominously for him, the Mexican just took it, blinked a bit, and came back punching. Look at Cantwell trying to counter with him. Tiznado, pressure, 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 working, working, working. And Cantwell largely matching him.
The new WBC International Light Flyweight Champion, Pablo Tiznado.
Excellent entertainment it was. Disappointment for Cantwell, but full marks for determination. Billy Schwer, I just wonder what his priorities are tonight after that setback.
Yeah, the last fight was a very tough fight, as we saw, but I'm sure he wants to get his confidence back, get back to winning ways and just a nice bit of boxing, I think.
So you'd call this one a pot boiler for him?
Yeah, it should be, yeah.
He has been nominated for a European title fight, and Frank Maloney, incidentally, is trying to win the purse bids for that one. But first, his opponent tonight, a novice professional, Anthony Hanna from Birmingham. We're hoping for a quality fight because the British Board of Control has done its job properly, turning down two suggested opponents for Cantwell on the basis of their records. So, Billy, the basis of that is going to be a tough night, but how much do we know about Hanna?
That's right, he's only had six fights, so myself, I don't know too much about him, but the Boxing Board of Control have done their job, and so he should be a good opponent for Mickey. Mm.
Never been beyond six rounds, we hear, so he's stepping up. We think this is eight tonight.
Eight rounds, yeah, so it'll be a step up for him.
What are the problems from his point of view about doing that?
Well, obviously, hopefully he'll have done all his work, make sure he's got plenty of stamina, so to last the eight rounds. Mm.
Norman Nobbs has apparently persuaded him to get his hair cut. In his early fights, you couldn't find his face as a target because of the hair falling in his eyes. But Cantwell will need to do a consistent night's work and re-establish his credentials.
Definitely so, especially with the European title fight maybe coming up. He's got to get back in there and do a good job on him tonight.
Right, let's get to Bristol for the first of our live action for you tonight. Can Cantwell dispense of this youngster, Hanna, or has the fight against Tiznado taken something away from Cantwell? We'll find out now. Our commentators, Glenn McCrory, and first, Ian Darr.
Welcome to Bristol, where there's a high expectation among the local crowd gathering here for the appearance of Ross Hale later on. First up, as Paul's been telling you, Mickey Cantwell, and this is going to be a bit of a rehabilitation fight for Cantwell tonight, up against Anthony Hanna, who's only 19 years of age, but has won three of his last four fights, Glenn.
He has, and I'm just going back to the fight that I seen him in. That was his fight with Fifield, who's now the Commonwealth champion. And he did quite well until he got stopped right at the end of the fight. But he's quite a good boxer. He's a good mover, and he's very, very game.
Well, here is Anthony Hanna coming into the ring with a record of 1-3, lost 3. He's from the Norman Nobbs camp in Birmingham. He's a former barman of the Birmingham nightclub. And he gave for Darren Fifield, who's now the Commonwealth champion, a pretty reasonable argument before he was stopped a few seconds from the end. And he says he's much more mature now, and he fancies this job tonight. He was asked by Norman Nobbs, do you want to fight Cantwell? He said, yep, sure, I think I can maybe cause an upset. He's very raw. He looks as if he's about 15, doesn't he?
He does. He looks very young. He's much improved with the haircut. Last time we saw him, he had very long hair and a ponytail, and he kept having to tie it up. So he looks a lot better for his new hairstyle.
It all used to flap in his face. It actually came loose in one of his fights with a fellow called Tiger Singh that he won earlier on this year. So next time he turned up in the gym, it was all nice and trim and ship-shape. I don't know, I quite liked the old hairstyle myself. Actually, I used to think it gave him a bit of character. But maybe it wasn't too practical. Anthony Hanna, he weighed in at 8 stone, 1 pound at the lunchtime weigh-in. That was 1 pound more than Cantwell, who was right on the normal flyweight limit of 8 stone exactly. good to see fighting coming to the end, boxing coming to the provinces. One of the biggest shows this they've had in Bristol for several years. It's a city that's never had even a British champion before now. They have good hopes that Ross Hale may do that and even achieve more. We'll see him later on. Now here comes Mickey Cantwell, who lives in Sidcup, though he always is introduced as being from Eltham in southeast London. 29 years of age, and his only defeat, that one you've seen, against Pablo Tiznado for the WBC international title. Cantwell, well, it was a defeat he could have done without, but my goodness me, he put up a stirring performance against a quality opponent that night.
He did. That was a very, very good fight. He fought back tremendously all the way through that, but Tiznado just had that little bit extra zing and a little bit extra class for Cantwell on that occasion. But I think the experience of that should have done him a great deal of good, and we'll see how much tonight, because it's a tough fight for him.
Your MC tonight is Mike Goodall. Let's hear from him.
Panics Entertainment, in association with McMahon Promotions and Chris Sanigar, and our sponsors this evening, Jarrett Construction, can I welcome you to an evening of international professional boxing from the Whitchurch Sports Centre in Bristol. We also extend a welcome to viewers throughout Great Britain on Sky Sports. Your officials this evening are all appointed by the British Boxing Board of Control, and the first contestants in the ring this evening are for a flyweight contest of 8 3-minute rounds. Between introducing in the red corner wearing the white trunks with the black trim from Birmingham, would you please welcome Anthony Hanna. His opponent in the blue corner wearing the yellow trunks is the official challenger for the European flyweight title from Eltham in London, Mickey Cantwell. At today's weigh-in, Hanna scaled 8 stone, 1 pound, Cantwell 8 stone. Your officials for this contest, the timekeeper, Mr. Ken Honeyball, the referee, Mr. Denzel Lewis of Bristol.
Local referee then, Denzel Lewis. And this a rehabilitation fight, you would think, for Mickey Cantwell. That's Dean Powell with him in the turtle top. But the best laid plans can sometimes be upset, as Tommy Morrison found out in fairly spectacular fashion the other night. Cantwell, who is on his way to a European flyweight title fight, he's the mandatory challenger for that. Cantwell in the yellow shorts with a big, big advantage in terms of experience over this novice Anthony Hanna from Birmingham in the white. Cantwell 10 years older, and just to give you another little indication, Cantwell had 104 amateur contests and Hanna had 4.
That's right, Cantwell was a very, very good amateur. And I think if you look at the records of both men, they're both pretty much boxers, but Cantwell has been boxing in a class above anything Hanna has.
Due to go 8 rounds this, and Anthony Hanna has never been in an 8-rounder before this. The furthest he's been is 6. It really was a hard fight as well that Cantwell had against Tiznado, and it was only 2 months ago, and I don't know, maybe ideally he would have wanted an even longer rest than that.
That's right, sometimes you need a rest, sometimes you need to be straight back in the ring. It's often difficult. The trainers and the managers usually know their own fight, and they know, you know, that I think they'll realise Cantwell hasn't had a lot of fights and he needs to be straight back in the ring.
Cantwell, it's always been quite a good little boxer. That nice stiff jab there from Hanna. Cantwell going for the body attack and mixing it up quite well. That uppercut was a decent shot as well. Whatever else happens here, I think Hanna might learn quite a lot tonight against an opponent of this quality.
Yes, Cantwell's starting very good. He's using some very good moves in close. He's switching the body and head very well. And he's got a nice rhythm.
I'm Well, he's finding the target with some regularity. Cantwell with the jab, and that was nice defensive skills as well from him. Nice and evasive. And Cantwell starting to get through with the combinations and mixing up the punches well. Nice repertoire. And some blood from Hanna's nose.
Yes, I think already Hanna's been hurt to the face with some solid shots. Working well to the body and then switching to the head. Cantwell.
Good right cross from him as well. Short punch, didn't travel very far. That one did, and I think it rocked Hanna a wee bit. That caught him round the side of the head. And fighters will tell you they get befuddled when punches land there.
That's right, anywhere around the side head, round the ear. With very hurtful shots.
That was a good round for Mickey Cantwell. That will make him feel a whole lot better coming off at a beat. Hanna going back to the corner, and he had to take quite a few stiff blows in that round, and his face rather shows the effects of that.
Yes, he's got a lot of blood around the nose. He took some nice shots. Cantwell was putting his shots together very well, going to the body first and then switching to the head, and that was not a good round for Hanna. He soaked up a little bit of punishment there. Here's some of Cantwell's work. That's a big overhand right hand. Landed right on the ear of Hanna.
Nicky Cantwell, 1-7, lost 1, drawn 1. The draw was against Louis Veitch when he came back to the ring after illness, and he had a bit of ring rust really that night, so I think you can probably ignore that result. In 1991 he won 5 out of 5. Last year had only one fight because of that illness, and he's come back this year with a good Southern Area title win over Darren Fifield, who's now the Commonwealth champion, and then that loss to Tisnado for the WBC international title. It's been a big year for Mickey Cantwell, and judging by that performance he had against Tisnado, maybe other championship fights could be coming his way. Just to remind you, Mickey Cantwell in the yellow trunks. Anthony Hanna just 19 in the white.
Campbell's working well. It looks as if his concentration is very good. He's got into his rhythm very quick in this fight. His defense is very good, his jabs, his hooks. And it just doesn't really know what to do with him.
Oh, he was caught by a big right cross again there, was Hanna. Again, that landed by the side of the temple. Cantwell having things much his own way at the moment. And Hanna, frankly, looking outclassed.
He does, he looks a little bit out of his depth. Cantwell's putting all good punches to work, and just about everything is landing.
Gain that right, but he's very game, he's very willing, is Anthony Hanna. He first started boxing when his brother took him down the gym when he was just 13 years of age, and I was speaking to him earlier and he said he just used to beat me up down there, and now I had to learn to fight. Tough old school, isn't it?
It is, and that's what brothers usually do.
Hanna's corner are calling out to him, relax, be a pro.
I think the problem that Hanna's having at the minute, he's not getting anything off. He's content to soak up punishment and try and use his defence. He really needs to try and get Cantwell off balance. He needs to stick his jab out and throw a few shots. He's letting Cantwell have everything his own way.
Quite apart from his repertoire so far, Cantwell. He's shown good defensive skills as well. Whenever Hanna has tried to land, he's usually found that the target is fairly elusive and there's quite good lateral movement of the head.
And one of the things that Cantwell showed in his contest with Tisnado was the abundance of heart. He was very, very good in that fight. He just couldn't put it together with a sharp opponent. But it was a good fight.
Last few seconds of this second round, and at the moment, Mickey Cantwell very much in charge of things. Can Hanna do something about it, you wonder? Welcome back to Bristol. This is Mickey Cantwell, really was a very good amateur. ABA finalist when Hanna, his opponent tonight, was just 7 years of age. He's a two times ABA champion in 1988 and 89, and in the 1988 final, he beat Robbie Reagan, that very good flyweight who went on to become European champion. He was an Acropolis Cup winner in Athens, and he fought in the Commonwealth Games as well. So this is a fighter with some pedigree, Mickey Cantwell, and at the moment, his young opponent looks as if he's in a bit too deep with him. Cantwell in the yellow shorts, Hanna in white. This is round three, it's due to go eight. Again, Cantwell's right hand. He's had plenty of success with that, Glenn.
He has. Every time he's through it, it's landed very well. It's a good shot he uses, pretty unorthodox, to lead with that big wide right hand, but Hanna doesn't seem to find anything to come back with. He's got to try and be a little bit more offensive, Hanna. He's letting Cantwell, you know, have too much of it his own way.
Well, the corner have been telling Hanna to relax. Of course, they're on the safe side of the ropes, but he does look quite stiff, quite tense, as he would be in with a fighter with as many moves and as much class as Cantwell.
That's right, I think that's the problem Hanna's having. He's just out of his depth a little bit. And he doesn't really know what to do. Cantwell's had loads of experience, a very good fighter who's come an awful long way from them amateur days.
Oh, good left hook from Hanna. That was probably his best punch so far, the right uppercut as well. And the Hanna camp say that everybody he's fought so far, they feel that at some point in the contest, he's just wobbled his opponent a bit. They think he has got a bit of punch power, though as yet he's got no knockouts on his record. But I thought for a moment there, he just buzzed Cantwell a little.
He did. He put a lot of effort into that left hook and it landed very well, flush on the jaw. It's a good shot, but he needs to throw more of them.
Now, whatever it was, Cantwell's head seems to have cleared now. But that was an encouraging moment for the young Anthony Hanna from Birmingham.
But Hanna cannot rely on that odd single shot. He's got to get more going. He's got to get the jab going. He's got to try and land that. Cantwell's coming straight in. So if Hanna landed the jab, it would work for him.
Oh, right hand from Hanna, and he had the left jab just before that. Cantwell still, though, does look a notch ahead of him. He's putting his punches together quite well in little bursts, is Mickey Cantwell. Punching in clusters. It's Hanna's best round yet, though.
It is. It's because he started to land a few shots. He started to throw some.
Getting more interesting here. Welcome back to the Whitchurch Sports Centre in Bristol. Live pictures. And there's Anthony Hanna, who did better in that third round. Oh, I wouldn't have given it to him on my scorecard, although he did have his successes.
That's right, he got a few more shots off. We see the left hook that he landed there. And he started to throw a few more shots towards the end of the round.
Fourth round, due to be an eighth round of this. Mickey Cantwell, winner of the Southern Area Championship earlier on this year against Darren Firefield in the yellow trunks. And Anthony Hanna in the white, the young man from Birmingham. In the corner between the rounds, they were telling Cantwell, don't stand back, go and throw two, three, four punch combinations and keep Hanna under pressure.
Yes, I think Dean Powell in Cantwell's corner feels that he can really take over this fight and probably get it over with if he really asserts himself. So they were asking for that little bit more. But Hanna's starting to throw a few shots.
this year. Hanna has had two wins over Peterborough's Tiger Singh. He beat the Birmingham featherweight Chris Lyons, who's one of his stablemates. Good right over the top that by Cantwell.
Again, Cantwell gets some shots off well. He's used that right hand, looks very solid as he's threw it over the top. He's rolling well as well.
Ooh, two big shots to the head there from Cantwell. He's not a concussive hitter by any stretch of the imagination, Cantwell. And if he had been, I think Hanna might have been on the floor, because they were quite big shots, and Cantwell really starting to throw caution to the wind and let the shots fly now.
He is, he's really loading up, he's planting them feet and really trying to swing these shots in. We saw Hanna try and grab for a little while there. I think he was hurt during some of them shots.
Cantwell would love the confidence booster of an inside the distance win on his return to the ring after that solitary defeat on his record against the Mexican Pablo Tiznado. And he's looking now to stand there and trade with Hanna. Not quite sure whether those are the wisest tactics from Cantwell, because it would appear to be Hanna's only real chance of getting lucky with one, but he really is, having said all that, putting the punches together with some style now, Mickey Cantwell.
He is, he's getting about his work, good body shots and head shots. I think he's trying to end the fight here. Hanna is certainly hurt and bleeding pretty heavily from either the nose or the mouth. I think Cantwell's doing the right thing. He needs to really assert himself, really put the pressure on and show Hanna that he's too good for him. He's just got to remember to keep rolling.
Four rounds gone here. I've given all four to Mickey Cantwell. What about you, Glenn?
I have as well. I think the third round, Hanna got in a little bit, but he didn't do enough to win the round. We're going to see some of the good work from Cantwell when he really started to load up. There's that right hand. He's been very successful throughout this fight with that punch.
It really did land flush, that, and you've got to give credit to Hanna. He is so game. But we have been saying he looks just a wee bit out of his depth here. Now, was it a good decision, do you think, by Norman Nobbs in the camp to let Hanna go in with Cantwell this early in his career? What do you think, Glenn?
Well, I don't think it was that great a decision, but I think they're looking at Cantwell as not being a really heavy puncher. So I think Norman Nobbs may think, well, this guy Hanna can get the experience that he maybe needs without getting hurt.
Again, the right hand, good hand speed as well from Cantwell when he threw it. And Hanna does score with his left hook.
Yeah, I've been impressed with the rolling that Cantwell's done. He's rolled well into his shots, he's thrown well to the body, and a very fast right hand.
Cantwell, of course, hoping for this European title shot. It's currently held by the Italian Luigi Camputero, though there's talk of him having a world title shot soon, so maybe the title will become vacant. That's best work yet from Hanna. Starting to put some punches together. Halfway through the fifth round. Well, Cantwell has dominated, but so far he's refused to quell the spirit of the young man in front of him.
He has. Hanna's still having a go. We've seen him before. We know he's tough. We know he'll give his all, but he is just a little bit out of his depth. I think it's a time where he's really got to clench his teeth and have a go. Let some shots go and see what he can pull out the bag.
One thing he's really having trouble matching, quite apart from anything else, is Cantwell's prodigious work rate.
Good shots in again, Mickey.
Come on, he don't like this.
Left hook, I think, landed on the gloves up time from Cantwell. Right hand didn't.
Well, Cantwell's working well inside. Every now and again he whips that right uppercut in. It's a good shot.
Five rounds gone, five rounds to Cantwell, we reckon. Dean Powell giving the instructions to Mickey Cantwell. They'll be fairly pleased, I would think, with development so far. In the other corner, Anthony Hanna, a remarkable interlude. Halfway through that round, Norman Nobbs in the corner there shouted to him, "Have a laugh." Have a laugh in a professional boxing match?
Yeah, I don't think he's having any laughs tonight.
It's certainly no comedy show in the ring.
No, and I think at this moment, Hanna knows how tough it is.
This is the sixth round. Hanna in the white shorts, just to remind you, Mickey Cantwell in yellow. In an ideal world, Hanna, who's got quite a good reach, should try to be working behind that jab a wee bit more, and he's started this round doing more of that than he's done at any other point in the contest.
That's right, this is what he's got to try and do. He's got to try and get his shots off, keep him at long range, and try and push Cantwell back a little bit. Cantwell's having it all his own way. He's marching forward, he's got his rhythm, he's letting his shots go. Hanna's got to try and disrupt that rhythm. The only way to do that is let his shots go, try and push him back.
Big snooker fan, I'm told, Mickey Cantwell. So far, certainly winning every frame here. Hanna just having this occasional success with the left hook, though, Glenn.
He does, he rolls himself round, really plants his feet and try and let that shot go. But the good head movement from Cantwell is denying him any success.
No titles or anything on the line here, so the referee will be the sole arbiter of how to score this, and I'd be very surprised if he had his scorecard saying anything other than Cantwell a long way in front. Of course, we'd know if Don King had his way. He's been suggesting that scorecards should be shown as the fight goes on. Do you agree with that, Glenn?
Well, we mentioned that the other day, and I don't think it's a good thing. I think the scoring system in this country works well the way it is.
Yes, you would tend to get fighters who found themselves a mile behind and in perhaps not the greatest condition trying to go for knockouts and making errors that they couldn't really be affording to make, leaving themselves open, perhaps knowing they needed the knockout.
That's right, that could
getting
be,
hurt.
That's right, that could be dangerous.
Well, six rounds gone, and Anthony Hanna, well, he will be learning things anyway, won't he? What will he be learning, do you think, Glenn?
I think in the morning he will learn how to take shots, because Cantwell's, he's given a good display. He looks very confident. I think his last fight against Tisnado has done him well. He's rolling very well. He's letting his shots go well. The combinations are good. And I think in Hanna's corner, he looks a little bit dejected, or a lot dejected. Nothing's going right for him. He keeps trying with that left hook, but it's just not working.
Well, I must say, my respect for Mickey Cantwell has grown in recent months, certainly in that Tisnado fight. It's often the way, I think it was with Evander Holyfield, when he lost to Riddick Bowe. People had more respect for him there than for any of the fights that he actually won. It was such a great performance by Cantwell, and you knew there that this was a fighter who was quite close to world level in his division, if not actually up there yet.
That's right. Often in defeat, a fighter shows more of his qualities.
And he was up against a really good little fighter, I thought, that night in Tisnado. This is the seventh here, and this is really the fight on the road back for Mickey Cantwell from that defeat. And I was questioning at the beginning whether maybe it was a bit too soon after such a hard fight, but Cantwell has shown no signs at all of lacking sharpness or looking a wee bit jaded.
Well, I think certainly the Tisnado fight has done Cantwell no harm at all.
When Hanna is landing, okay, throws arm punches a little, doesn't he?
He does, especially the jab. He's taller and he has a better reach, so really he should step in with that jab. But he just sort of levers it out. There's no power behind it.
Cantwell's getting on a bit, really, for a man at this weight, 29 years of age. Usually flyweights are past their peak by this age, but there are always exceptions to the rules.
There is, and I think he proves because he's had very few professional fights. So I think, you know, he's less shop-worn, so his career will last longer.
This is only the 10th, in fact. He was a late starter as a pro at the age of 27. Cantwell dominating without ever looking like he's going to put his man away.
It's a good workout for Cantwell, this. He's getting all the work he needs. He's mixing his shots up well. He's getting all the practice that a fighter can have.
It was quite a good fight he had with Darren Fifield as well, wasn't it? I wonder if those two might get back in again together.
Well, I think that's a fight he's got to be looking to have, especially with Fifield winning the Commonwealth title. He's picked the pace up a little bit now, Cantwell.
It's a hard night this now for Anthony Hanna. He's in new territory in this seventh round. He'd only ever been six before. But he'll want to say that he went the distance with one of the top men in his division in the country. And at the moment, he does look like achieving that goal anyway.
Yes, he does. Cantwell's never really had Hanna in any serious trouble. He's kept the pressure on, he's worked well, and he's, you know, he's dominated the fight. But he's never had him, you know, rocking and rolling around the floor.
It's a pity, really, for Cantwell that he is not a big puncher. He doesn't have the punch of, say, a Charlie Magri at this weight.
That's right, but he has very good combinations. We saw there a left-right and doubled up the left hook. And he has a very good work rate.
Good technician.
He has, but I think that comes from, you know, so many years in the very top class as an amateur.
If he just had that one other piece to the armory, some firepower, he really may be able to go places, but and he still might be able to. Last round, 3 minutes to go, three more minutes for Hanna, and I think that's about as much as he would really want. Norman Nobbs is still in there talking now. What's the delay here? I don't know what that was about. Any ideas, Glenn?
I'm not sure. I think they're just giving time for Norman Nobbs to have some last instructions. He seemed pretty happy with his man.
Eighth and last round then, Mickey Cantwell in the yellow shorts. And I think he's pitching for the shutout here on my scorecard anyway. How about yours, Glenn?
Yes, I think he's won every round. Hanna's put a little bit of resistance up, but certainly not enough to grab any rounds. It's a good comeback for Cantwell. I think his management will be happy with this performance.
Always been a good little division, this one, for British boxing as well. We've always seemed to have men knocking on the world title door. And in recent years, you can think of Charlie Magri and Duke McKenzie and Dave Boy McCauley. And there's a whole string going back in history as well. Again, the right hand from Cantwell. Just getting eight solid rounds under his belt. And will feel all the better for it. Unless, of course, Hanna can produce some jackpot punch from somewhere, though there's been precious signs that he's about to do that.
Well, it's always possible, but I think Cantwell's just got to, he's got to keep concentrating right till the end of this fight. He's got to keep rolling and letting his shots go, just as he did there.
Still to come, remember here, we have the local hero, Ross Hale, in a very important fight for him against Regino Caceres. Hale, who's on a four-fight package, which he hopes will end in a shot at the IBF title against Charles the Natural Murray. And that's the one, really, that the Bristol crowd will be getting up for tonight. Cantwell here having things much his own way in this last round now.
Yes, he's finishing this fight well. He's put some nice combinations together.
It's not a fight that's going to go into anybody's scrapbook as part of their golden greats of boxing or anything like this, but it's quite an interesting little workout again for Mickey Cantwell. He's answered one or two questions. And Hanna, as we thought beforehand, Glenn, sorry to interrupt you there, just not quite good enough, is he,
no,
for this man?
But, Cantwell Camp wouldn't have wanted a really tough one, not after the Tisnado fight. They need to bring their man back steadily. And I think this is a sensible fight.
Bell goes to end it. I think they both know the result. And there it is confirmed for you. Denzel Lewis, the referee, lifting the hands of Mickey Cantwell, who must have been a very big points winner of that contest over Anthony Hanna. Frank Maloney in the ring. Mickey Cantwell's promoter. Blood on the face of Hanna. And a little nick as well under the left eye for Cantwell at the end there too. Must have happened in the last round, I think.
I think Hanna's Cantwell will be pleased that he went the distance. I think that's a triumph for him in itself.
And my scorecard there says 80-76, every round to Mickey Cantwell. I wonder if the referee agreed with it. We'll find out now.
Ladies and gentlemen, the referee, after eight rounds of boxing, has scored the contest. Anthony Hanna, 77.5 points. Mickey Cantwell, 80 points. The winner there, Mickey Cantwell.
Well, a few rounds were level, according to the three even, said the referee, which I think might be a little bit generous, but doesn't make much odds. Cantwell, as we thought, winning it big. And the European title could be next for him. Hanna has to stay on the undercards for a while longer yet.
Game young fella though, wasn't he? Billy Schwer watching with me here in the studio. What did you make of that performance from Mickey Cantwell, your old amateur buddy?
Yeah, I was well pleased with the way he boxed. He should be delighted with that. He's back on his winning ways, and it couldn't happen to a nicer guy. He's a really nice guy.
Looked nice and relaxed.
He did, yeah.
He
was working well inside. He's boxing well, so he should be pleased with that.
Now, you know what they're going to say about Mickey, don't you, Billy? They're going to say he's very, very good when he fights at British level.
That's
but
right.
When he's asked to step up to fight against international class opponents and top world-class opponents, that's when the problems start. Would you go along with that?
Yeah, that's right. You do get problems when you start moving up a class, obviously. So hopefully he'll have learned from that fight. He's going to go back in the gym and carry on learning and hopefully improving and be able to lift himself and get up to those standards.
What are the things you'd be urging him to improve upon?
Well, his boxing ability is great. He can box very well. Just maybe his punch a little bit, if he could increase the power in his punch. But his boxing ability is great.
Mm. So he's still hoping to have a crack at the European champion. That's a title held by Giovanni Camputari. We don't know a lot about him, but you feel that Mickey's got work to do before he's ready for that, do you?
Oh, yeah, he's obviously going to have work to do for a European title fight, but I'm sure he can do it. He's got it all there, so it could happen to a nicer bloke if he wins a European title.
Game, young fella, Hanna. Was it a fight they should have taken at this stage, do you think?
That's arguable. It's a tough fight for him. He's only had six fights, but he performed beyond the call of duty. He was very game, very tough, and he done really well. Fair play to him.
More from Billy Schwer in just a moment or two. Just to remind you, we've got some more top-class live action coming up here on Sky Sports. We're going up to light welterweight next, and the local boy is on show in Bristol. He's a man with a little bit of a reputation already. Ross Hale on the left of your picture. An unknown quantity, the Colombian Regino Cáceres, is the opponent, and it could be pretty exciting. We'll see you again after this.
You're watching Sky Sports.